it's kind of a cautiously optimism in the market. And I will say cautiously optimism because there is a lot still have a good buzz. Golf is lots of markets are very enthusiastic about it, but the overall world economy kind of temper some of the enthusiasm. Lots of the key retailers, they're not sure how much the consumer want to spend. There's also a bit of saturation, lots of inventory sitting in a store. But overall, the buzz is there, and you have some products which are doing very well, and you got lots of products which are sitting and collecting dust. So if you are one of them who are checking out, you're in a good position, and we have some of that success. But you also hear they are very cautious, very worried about some market. I was in Malaysia the last few days. Overall, they are very positive, very happy over there. Indonesia was surprisingly, I haven't spent too much time in the store, but overall, it's a booming market. You can feel the enthusiasm in Indonesia. Lots of it's one of those growing places, and it was nice to see. On the other hand, you know, in Australia, there is positive, there is happy over there, but they are more cautious because mainly their currency versus the US dollars is kind of 1-to-1 at the moment. And they are a bit more cautious of what's happening around the world with the overall economy, and you will see it with specifically in Europe, they seem some markets are kind of slowing down. Yeah. Oh, Asia is a big part of the world, yeah, it's a big market. US is still the number one market. You got Japan, which is your number two. You've got Europe, which is a key one with UK, Sweden. The Asia market, the sad part is so fragmented, and the distribution network is still at its infancy. You have a distributor in one market, you have a subsidiary in another market. The infrastructure of distribution is not there yet. And also, there's still lots of politics going on between the organization and between the golf course, the superintendent. That is starting to grow. You see some markets are doing very well, and I just mentioned Malaysia. In Malaysia, I was playing a golf course, Palm Garden. Great facility, and you can see everything works great. The course management, that was work, and you have a lot of examples like this in Malaysia. You go in Indonesia, some places they don't seem to, and the greenkeeper and the pro shop and what's retailing, they don't seem to work together. So, and after that, in terms of distribution, well, it's not that simple. As you were aware, Indonesia coming up now imposing the new duty rate on golf club and on golf ball. And we're talking heavy duty, 50% and 40%. So that is going to kind of temper the market as well. So it's pocket. You got some places which are great, some pockets are still growing up. Some work to be done. Well, Kevin has been with us for the last few years, and we've been working a lot with him with his product, and he moved to the new FG Tour clubs a couple of years ago. He now gained that confidence. He's very happy with his product. Earlier this year, he won in Tampa, and that was a big win for him. It was his first win on the PGA. And last weekend, he finished second at the Players, and that's what considered the fifth major, basically, on the tour. So he's building that momentum. I think he's now reaching that point of time. I will not be surprised to see him winning more this year, and maybe we could be lucky having a 62nd major with Kevin, yes. Padraig is basically associated with Wilson. Padraig Harrington, Wilson staff, it's a long story. He's basically spent all his life with us. He had three majors, so it's not a small achievement. He's very much there. I think we can see Padraig winning another major and some tournament, but like every player, you know, you got some period, you're hot, you got some player, you're a bit cool. He's working hard on his game. I think he made lots of progress again on his game, and here as well, I will not be surprised seeing him winning a couple of more tournaments pretty soon. Wilson will be 100 years next year. 2014 will be the 100th anniversary of Wilson. So we've been in the business for a long time. But yes, we have 62 majors under our belt as a brand, and there's not too many people. The closest behind us doesn't exist anymore. So we've got a very strong. But the 62 majors, lots of people say a lot of your majors were won in the 60s or 70s. They are still relevant. We won three majors the last 10 years, so it's every decade we have one major, so that's it's very relevant. And yes, it's a pretty good achievement, and it really shows that we've been in the business for a long time, and we know we make equipment and has got a pretty good track record. Well, D100s, if you talk driver specifically, the D100 driver, it was designed to be a super light driver. As you know, the club is only a 46 gram shaft. The overall weight of the club is less than 300 grams. So it's a very light driver, but it's the right weight because the grip weight, the shaft weight, the head weight make it then it feels as a regular golf club. So at your top of your swing, you don't lose the driver. We can make a very light shaft, but then your head weight and your grip doesn't match up together. Having a light golf clubs help a lot. The average golfer, when he swings to keep control of his club, generate more head speed, to the point that we've seen at demo days, and we've seen it at a lot many demo days around the world, when people try the golf club, there is a wow effect. So it's a very simple story. It doesn't have all the adjustment that you can see in the market, to the point that the club was in a hot list. It's the only non-adjustable driver in the hot list this year. Some major retailer in the USA did also some independent testing, and D100 was present in all their selection as one of the top performance drivers. So for the average golfer, and even for the better, because we see some of our sales force or some of their, it's a golf club which is very easy to play. And it's a very simple story. It's a very lightweight golf club, so you got lots of control with it, and you generate the head speed. The iron followed the same story, the hybrid. So the old D100 was very much designed as being a lightweight line of product for the average golfer. The D100 iron is very much your game improvement with a very wide sole, and that has been very well also been very, very well received. Yeah, we see some good success on the product. But the iron is very much driven today, as you know, if you don't have a driver, everything starts with the driver. You go to a demo day, the first thing people want to do is to pull the driver. So we've been very focused on irons, and we're still very focused on irons, but having a driver which basically helps to fuel the iron business is a good thing. Well, let me, yeah, the Duo golf ball, it's a very, very unique story. If I go back in history, Wilson, just about 7-8 years ago, we were already making golf ball at 50 compression. Wilson golf balls now, and it's been for the last 7 or 8 years, low compression technology. That Duo golf ball today is a 40 compression golf ball. So it's a very soft golf ball, but it's as long as anything else. So for the average golfer, or even player which are a lower handicap, you've got a golf ball which shoots very soft. Because in a two-piece category golf ball, distance golf ball, you can make golf ball, but they always been tend to be very hard. And people today, they say, well, they're looking for the feel. So you get the feel when you go into the multi-layer constructions, but having a golf ball which is so soft, and at the same time, which gives you the same distance as everything else, that way is happening. And every testing you do, people do the rebounds testing. We do that with some major retailer where people do the drop the duo challenge. You take the two ball, let them drop. They can see the ball rebouncing. If the ball rebounds higher, it means one thing. You got a higher COR. Imagine what it does when you hit with the face of your golf club. Also, what you can do is when you bounce the ball on the floor, you can hear how soft it is. If the ball doesn't clink, it has got that soft sound. And so it shows you that the ball is very, very soft. So today the ball has been in quite a few retailers, their number one distance ball category. It's been one of the best selling ball in quite a few major retailers across USA. Here in the region, in Malaysia, the Duo ball has been doing very, very well with our partner MST. So we've seen some very strong pockets of success. And I was in Australia the last few days, and they're starting to put some fuel behind it. And this is a good success story for us, yes. Probably going to see some extension in the Duo family, but the Duo as we know it will remain. The line D100, as I just mentioned, was a brand new line in 2013, so that's going to remain for 2014, and we're going to concentrate most of our new product development on what we call our C category, which is our control, and the F category, which is our forged field player. So we cover this year the base of the market, which is the bulk of the business. You got like over 60-70% of the market, which are the distance category. And for 2014, we will have the higher end of the pyramid, which is C category, which is we will have probably a new C irons there. And we will have a brand new line of FG product coming out, yes. And it would be interesting to see, because the FG line next year is going to be very impressive. Lots of good things coming up there.